Now, normally on this channel as well, I really tend to do a lot of videos on the programming in general. But apart from programming, I do tend to read a book which I really find intriguing as well. And in this week, I really happened to read this book called Mastery by Robert Greene as well. Now, this book really goes in depth into the much more elaborative stuff that you can really assume to really get into your career epitome as well. Now, you may ask, why are you reviewing this book? Well, I'm not really actually reviewing this book, and I'm not a professional reviewer. By the way, there are much more beautiful channels out there dedicated to really book review of this book as well. Well, what I'm really trying to do is I'm really going to share what I really learned from this book. And you may ask, why are you sharing this, by the way? Because everyone kind of really wants that to achieve that overleap or extra miles of success to really live their life more meaningful and live their life more fulfilled as well. And to attain that state of mastery is the actual and the real power. That's what Robert Greene says, by the way. So, and this, the interesting part about this book is, this book isn't really, you know, a soft core or really, you know, soft BS type of books out there, self-help books out there, which really says you, you know, which makes you feel good about yourself, which makes you feel this about all that thing as well. The particular style of this about Robert Greene is much more I really like about it. He has a particular style of, you know, taking all of this master together from Leonardo da Vinci, Mozart, Johann Wolfgang Goethe, Buckminster Fuller, and various others as well, which I'm really forgetting, by the way. He has taken everything and he has really illustrated such a thing as well, that every information of this book really goes within your skin as well. And that is a much more good powerful thing as well. So what I really learned from this book, especially now, to be fair, this book is around, let's say, 336 pages. Around on Audible itself is 16 hours of Audible book. But I can't cover everything. But what I can cover is the major highlight that I really found much more exciting and interesting to really begin with as well. So, and I have wrote on this my diary as well, if you can see. And I'm going to really elaborate on the much deeper as well. So let's talk about what this mastery is all about. What really separates Leonardo da Vinci, Albert Einstein, Mozart, Johann Wolfgang Goethe, Benjamin Franklin, and many others as well? The fact is that they are able to really follow their own instinct as well. It's really not that they were really genius, although yes, they were. But Robert Greene really says that if you really look closely upon and study about all of these people's lifespan as well, you will really see an innate trait or the capability that really makes them separate as well. And it's really not that those qualities are really some sort of a magical as well. Even you and me can really follow and pick all of these characteristics and implement in our own life to make our life more meaningful as well. So, and one of this quality is around follow your inner calling and know your true self. Well, this is the most inner quality as well. We often really tend to see a lot of, you know, highly successful people or, you know, epitome of their career as well. Really, like, they are earning lakhs of rupees. They are, you know, earning well, but still somehow they are really feeling miserable or somehow they are feeling really meaningless. And it's really like they haven't really find their inner passion as well. The reason might go endless as well. Now, you might particularly know that some people are just behind the money as well. And some people really like to do various things as well. Now, intention may be whatever it is. So, if you can really pick a career option which is close to what you are especially, which is close to your inclination, close to what you think, believe and act as well, the greater fulfillment and the greater joy that you fill up right there. Most of the time, let's say 70% of the people don't really tend to enjoy what they do up right there. And this isn't a really good case condition for considering for what we want to make our economy more fulfilled as well. And this is something which really you need to care about. And how can you really just figure out what your inner calling is? And that leads to the second point about follow your childlike curiosity. This is, I can't stress about how important this is. So since childhood, you were just kind of really growing up right there. Everyone since the childhood, what Robert Greene says, that consider yourself as a unique entity as well. The kind of genes, the kind of DNA that you have is really that has never existed before, and that will never be replicated by nature anytime sooner as well. So you are one of your kind itself, you know, just like that Instagram quote really says, then that is really true. Since childhood, you are having some sort of an inclination, you are some sort of a curiosity, or you some sort of an care spark to really know the things and to really observe the surrounding in a much more meaningful way. That was really meaning and really personal to you. That was really fulfilling and really joyful to you as well. But as we really tend to grow, we tend to dilute our inner voice from the external circumstance as well. We don't give an emphasis on what that inner voice or that inner child is feeling up right there. So, and it's really important to listen to your ability or to listen to your own inner self and to really channelize and to really learn and to proceed accordingly as well. Which really leads to my third point about channelize your energy. Now, there are various kinds of people in this world out right there. One is being optimist, one is being pessimist, one is being really, you know, hypervigilant. There are many kinds of as well. Now, depending upon how your outlook is, like, let's say I tend to do already conservative things, or I tend to have some sort of a negative approach to this society as well. So, well, there is not a problem in really how you look, but this is certainly a problematic if you not really channelize this energy into the right way as well. So since if you really have a particular, if you have a resentment or if you have really anger to some sort of a particular thing as well. Now, instead of really ranting or complaining about all those things as well, you should take those energy which you have within you and use that and channelize within your work to reflect that kind of perfectionism, or to really, you know, to kind of really engrave your anger or fire within you. Now, this word is really have. Now, this example is really particularly applicable to my instance as well. Now, depending upon what you are, what your nature is, it might be different for you as well. But instead of really always, you know, it's really often that we really see. We tend to kind of really waste our time on various online as well. We tend to really think about is really on that thing instead of doing all of these things as well. We should kind of really channelize into our energy into some meaningful and productive thing as well. And the fourth point really leads me to is, and the fourth point really leads me to is ideal apprenticeship. You should always value learning over money, at least in your early 20s or in the during the college or let's say higher education learning days as well. Now, the fact is that I really like, let's say if you are really want to just focus on earning money as well, try know what you will eventually try to, what you will eventually end up in doing is you will be always constantly trying to impress others. You will be constantly, constantly be judging about how will other perceive me? How will, you'll be always be stressed and worried about how will other, how my boss will think about myself as well. And how will others really look upon? How can I please him, other person, so that I can get more money and to do other thing as well? Instead, you should always focus on learning as well. No matter how shitty is the condition, environment is. Now, ideally, you should choose a better workplace as well. That is one of the points that I would really suggest. But yeah, it's really like you should be initially during your days about free about all of these shackles about earning the money as well. I would say yes, money is important. But first, you should really know about your shit properly as well. And to know that shit properly, you need to learn first, and that is why learning does matters properly as well. No matter where you work, what is your, if you are working on internship as well, you should not really focus on the money aspect properly as well. Although, again, I would say that is important, but you should focus on, emphasize on learning aspect as well. Because that learning will help you to really achieve the level of mastery or achieve the level of competence in your own skill and the level of the things that you really achieve, want to do itself. Let's say if I'm really in computer as well, let's say in the programming as well, I'm just beginning out with a Kotlin as well, let's say in Android development, and I happen to get some internship. So what I'll really do is I'll learn some of the things as well, Now, eventually, my level was 20. Now, what I really do within that internship as well, my level goes from 20 to directly 80. And that rest above 20% is left that I really need to cover up right there. So, learning does enhance your experience and abilities to deal with various scenarios as well, which has its own monetary value in the long term as well. So, I would say the more you learn, the more you will earn. Traditionally, you might have heard that as well. So, and the next point that really leads me is about learning is find a good mentor. You know, I can't really stress enough about how important point is this. Now you may, if you have watched some of the self-help videos out right there, you may sound, you are you selling something like fake gurus or something like that? And the answer is no, I'm not really selling any fake gurus. The fact is our lifespan is quite short. You can do a limited amount of trial and error to really just kind of really succeed in your life. And getting the shortcut to your success or to the mastery as well is to find a mentor as well. Because the mentor is the straightforward and clear-cut shortcut to the mastery as well. The mentor can really guide you on a particular aspect much more than you can do a trial error hit as well. So let's say I will give you my example as well. Let's say I happened to struggle a lot about serverless and AWS in general. Now, AWS, for those who don't know, is a cloud computing as well. That is what I'm really learning. So and I was really having a lot of trouble and time about to really learn a lot of concepts about serverless in general. Now, recently I came to know a person in last 4 months, Jan Kiwi. He's a serverless hero. Now, it's a AWS program called Recognizing the People Who Really Do a Contribution About the Serverless and in various stuffs in general. But regardless of all those things as well, what really happened about me is really like I approached him that he was holding his own course called Production Ready and it was $800. Now, actually being an Indian as well, now I'm a student, I just can't afford him. So I really approached him with my own problem that I'm really struggling with this topic and I have my own YouTube channel. So, and I'm really doing all these things and he graciously offered me free course about this thing. And the level of knowledge that he had was immense. I was really, you know, utterly mesmerized by the level and the depth of his knowledge as well. So one thing that really happened is, you know, so before my level of knowledge about serverless was around 40 to 50-ish, something like that. And after taking that course in just within 1 month as well, my level is right now is about 70 to 80, something like that. So, and obviously there is AWS is much more crazy stuff to deal with, which I'm really going to do it right now as well. But yeah, none of the regardless stuff is really like finding a mentor really helps you to cut your time during that path as well. So, and one of the thing is really that it will really help you to speed up your process, as I really previously mentioned before. Now, talking about finding mentors as well. Now, Robert Greene really goes into a bunch of illustrative examples. Let's say about Michael Faraday as well. Now, Michael Faraday was initially a kind of a religious person due to his family as well. He used to see God-like presence in every stuff as well. Since he was really religion, he used to see God-like presence in every stuff as well. But naturally, he was so genius. He was so inclined to a particular thing as well. But he was really poor. Now, in back those days, going to the college and universities could really afford, rich class or, you know, high class people as well. And he was not really being able to do that as well. So since what he really did is actually they were used to a bookshop near in his town as well. One day what has really happened is he came to that bookshop as well. And that bookshop owner was really mesmerized by this young Faraday's ability to all read all those books and to really encapture all this knowledge with vivid details and vivid illustration as well. So laterwards, he really found a professor called Humphrey Davy in the Royal Institution. And laterwards, he really made Humphrey Davy as his own mentor as well. Now, there was initially some challenges as well, which Robert Greene has mentioned in vast detail about in his book as well. And what we really study about this character, about Michael Faraday himself, was really sculpted during those 20 years of mentorship in his Humphrey Davy itself. And you might say about, hey, What about those people who are not really able to find some mentor as well? Well, in today's world as well, we don't need to do all of these things as well, because we can find virtual mentors on this YouTube video as well. Learn all of these things, read their books and to grasp their knowledge in virtual manner as well, without even meeting them as well. So the Robert Greene has given a wonderful example about how Thomas Alva Edison was one of the greatest inventors. He was also born poor actually, but he was not having an access to school. He was not having access to anything as well, just like Michael Faraday as well. So, and he was in kind of a pure curious autodidact as well. Autodidact means a self-learned person as well. So, and that's how it really goes. And the next point that really leads me to is sacrifice. In order to really achieve the path of mastery, or to really walk on the path of mastery as well, you will need to do an order of sacrifice as well. So it's an innate rule of life. You know, you just can't avoid suffering at all. So no matter what you do, whatever your situation is, it's just inevitable part of your life as well. So, and if you can find the suffering or the sacrifice in a really meaningful way as well. So let's say a lot of people days are really kind of really suffering, but they are not finding a meaning as well. But let's say you are really doing something. So let's say if you really like badminton as well, and you are crazily obsessed about it, you really do, you really like to do a bunch of practice all day along as well. So in that case as well, you really need to do some sacrifices, like, you know, not being some social, not being some practice, to really, you know, bunch of crazy other stuff as well, in order to really achieve all those things as well. You can't have everything in your life as well. Let's say I really desire many times I really desire that I should have a MacBook or Mac Mini as well, to really to test and try some, to learn an Xcode or Swift programming, or for iOS in general. Or let's say I should have, you know, my own custom built powerful PC, let's say RTX 3000 series card, or let's say anything as well, to really learn Blender on, to really to just test the 3D models in general as well. But you can't have everything as well, and it to achieve that level of mastery and that financial status takes time as well. And Robert Greene really says that to really see the tangible result of what you are doing right now, in order to walk the path of mastery as well, you at least need to wait, or at least need to work at least 4 or 5 years to at least see the return on investment about what you are doing up right there. The path of mastery isn't really straightforward as well, and it's just a matter of your shame and embarrassment to really just deviate from the path as well. Oftentimes, we really just conform by the pressure of society. We really fall into the conformity trap, and it's sadly that, you know, most of the people out there that we see, they fall into those traps as well, and which is not really good as well if you want to get on the track of mastery as well. And that really leads me, and the point of sacrifice leads me about embarrassing pain as well. I can't stress this enough as well. We are living in such an age that we don't feel any urgency. Most of our parents are financially well laid off. It's really like, I'm assuming that your financial parents' condition is well off at least. You are having a decent quality life, which you sure, considering you have this mobile or laptop or internet, decent internet condition, that you're watching this video up right here. And the problem with this really, you know, the social media is really taking at this level to the another level as well. So we have a lot of anxiety, we have a lot of technical issues, whether it's really dealing with our own mental pressure as well. And considering to the point of female, it's, you know, the results are really much more worse as well, really, because in case of females as well, it really deteriorates, or it really kinds of makes them feel worse about themselves as well, which is not really true. And this is an entire different, I can make an entire different topic on this video as well. But it's really like, but due to this social media as well, people find distracted, and they find, and as always, these kinds of apps are really designed to really hit you dopamine instantly as well, just within the endless infinite scroll, tap, swipe, do, and various all of the gestures as well. We don't have that level of attention span as well to really just stick to some particular topic and really watch that video or let's say watch or learn any particular topic thoroughly as well. A lot of times as well, you know, recently I have got my comment as well, like, hey, you should make shorter video as well. Well, I can, I have no doubt in making all that thing as well. But the fact is that I can't just compress the whole entirety of this topic and the vastness of this video or the detail of this video in just 4 or 5 minutes as well. And a lot of friends as well might see that, why can't you make this video shorter as well? What's the problem in making such a long video as well? And when I really try to really know about why they are saying that, I often get the inner insight. It's just really like, they are not really habitual to stay and stick along. Their mind is kind of really hyper activated every time as well. And that is really symptoms regarding an ADHD as well. Like, let's say hyperactive attention disorder, hyperactive deficiency, something like that. Yeah. If I'm wrong, please correct me. And considering all this about social media phenomena itself, it's really not good for us to walk, considering if we want to really walk on the path of mastery as well. In order to really walk on the path of mastery or to achieve the level of mastery as well, you really need to do a sacrifice, as we talked before. And in order to do sacrifice, you need to have an immense ability to endure pain for a really long period of time as well, whether it's emotional, whether it's mental, whether it's physical, or whether it's of any kind as well. And you should really be aware of your own self and be really stay away from all those things as well. And the next point that really leads me is what I've really learned that I really find valuable is, be on a creative endeavor and learn whatever excites you. Journey towards mastery isn't a state. Now, oftentimes we have seen this meme about, let's say, the journey about success is what we really assume is a straight path, but oftentimes it really is a rumbleness up right there. And to really give an example about this, Robert Greene has mentioned one example about Yoki Matsuoka, and to really demonstrate about she was really special since from childhood as well. Now, it was really not that it were her dressing sense or her presenting style make her really separate from really other girls as well. So what really made her separate was her inclination towards a sport like tennis, really like sociology, physical, and very, very STEM field as well. So what really happened is really like in her childhood as well, she really dreamed about what would really happen as she was a tennis player as well. What would really happen if a tennis robot, or let's say if a robot could play her tennis with her as well. So after really growing up, she came to US as well to study electrical engineering. And laterwards, she really did her PhD in electrical and artificial intelligence as well. So laterwards, she was really offered to work on the robotic hand in an MIT lab as well. So what really happened is she felt a need about to learn the neuroscience as well, about how our arms really work, how our body really works. So what really she really did is, right, instead of following all the conventional approach about what her fellow colleagues were doing, she really just went on to just study about how our hand really works, what are the muscles, how our bones about really actually functions as well. And it was innate desire and innate study about this hand structure that really led her to really know that where those motors and where those all the neurons, let's say motors in the prosthetic arm, should be placed as well. She later, by studying about the neuroscience about the arm as well, she really later realized that it was just this thumb as well which has the massive power among all those fingers as well, and every strength in the prosthetic arm should be placed in that thumb as well, in the motor as well. So laterwards, her study and her research became the industry standard in the prosthetic arms and various as well. So in this case, if you really look upon her, her path was not clearly straightforward as well, but the eventually end result was monumentally fabulous as well. And Robert Greene himself has its own, you know, let's say crazy, you know, endeavor journey as well. He was having a rough path till the age of 36 as well, and laterwards everything suddenly just clicked into the one place, and that's how he really wrote the book about 48 Laws of Power, which you can also find his video in the upright corner as well. And also I'll mention all the related Robert Greene talks on the mastery as well in the link in the description as well. But yeah, his path was not straight struggle, but eventually whatever he really struggled, whatever he really read, it just came into one place, and that's how it is succeed, and that's how we are really doing a book analysis of today itself, really, like, hey. And the next point that is really that I really find it intriguing was ability to socialize and properly deal with people as well. Now, it doesn't really matter whether you are great Albert Einstein or great Alexander, no matter how genius you are, if you can't able to socialize with people or can't able to know and to really match up with you, if your social skills are terrible as well, you would have an immense, immense problem as well. So to really illustrate this problem as well, Robert Greene has really talked about one person called Ignaz Semmelweis as well. What really happened is today, so today as we really knew that before any medical procedure or before any some sort of an operation as well, the doctors kind of really wash their hands to really just kind of disinfectant their hand as well. And oftentimes we really see many advertisement that, you know, we should wash our hands, we should do really some stop of the contamination, to spread the contamination and to really make ourselves really sick less as well. But it was really time about 1846 as well. It was really the medical science wasn't really that progressed as well. A lot of people were really dying due to many diseases, contagious of the germs as well. But this man really discovered about the thing about this using disinfectant or really washing his hands with germicides as well. But the problem really, he really implemented, and the rate of deaths were really half in just 1 week instantly. But the later words problem really arise is that he really started to preach his solution to the various other universities and to medical hospitals as well. But the problem is that, you know, everyone is kind of really addicted to their own human nature as well. And the Semmelweis was kind of a really ignorant and arrogant person as well. So he was not really able to convince other people really in much more elaborate manner about why should he really use it. And other people were reluctantly refusing his practice to do and to really just say, hey, we are not going to do it. So instead of really trying to really go to the systematical procedure about writing a paper, writing a document, he did none of them as well. And he utterly died in much more as well. You know, pieces really in worse manner as well. To the counterpart, here Robert Greene also talks about Benjamin Franklin. Now, as we know that we in terms of psychology itself, there is a term called Benjamin Franklin effect, or you know, aka the favor effect as well. So, in order to make someone really like you as well, you need to kind of have, let's say, someone is kind of really not liking you as well, and to make the person really like you, you need to make that person do some small favor substantially to make that person like you as well. So let's say why that person will really not, let's say if you want a book from someone as well, some of your friend as well, he will only just do a small favor to you if he like you as well. So in order to gain that trust, in order to be that social as well, in order to really get that approval as well, in some of the cases, you really need to do and to use that effect as well. And Benjamin Franklin was excellently, brilliantly social. His social skills were absolutely at par, at the best as you can ever imagine up right there. So that really leads to the point about having the socialize as well. Now the next point is never be complacent. The fact is that it's really, you know, at the point of our career, we see many people, especially the college student as well, the way we are taught in a way is really like we just kind of hate. We are just mugging and cramming directionally about what we really want. It's like we are forcefully fed the information which we really don't like. And that really takes away about our own inner self as well. And naturally, being unhappy, we tend to do a job which we really hate just for the sake of make a living as well. And many people, whether you learn a skill as well, or whether you like it or whether you do not, many people stay complacent as well because, you know, they think that we have learned this much skill, we are earning this much, and we are satisfied as well. Instead, you should always continue to progress and learn as much thing as you really can do and like as well. And that really leads me to the next point about don't be conservative, inflexible, and impatient. This is much more important than anything else. Now, in order to really open your mind as well to really various stuff, you need to kind of have an open mind as well. So in order to basically learn everything, let's say if you are really watching this video up right here, you have came and you have clicked this video in order to learn something as well. That means you have kept your mind open to what information that I'm really giving up right here. And that is the most important thing about learning as well. You can't be actually learning at all with the old conservative mind and old assumption as well. You need to have a really fresh perspective. You need to have a blank, you need to have a mind like a blank slate as well. You need to have just kind of write everything as well with the own with throwing all away all the biases as well that you really have as well. And that really leads, and the third point that I really talked about is impatient as well. I have seen a lot of my friends as well who are really impatient. They just want to, you know, they are not even in the completed the first year, but they still, they really want to earn money as well. And that is really not good as well. So, and let's say like, you know, I have learned this much amount of programming as well, or I have learned this much amount of skill as well. I'm really now, I've finished. I was really stuck. I've finished right now. And the fact is, learning never stops in life, or else your earning will stop. The fact is, you know, the impatient really kills a motive out the path of mastery as well, and you should be aware about it. And this book really goes into much more depth and example about all those historic figures that I'm really talking about right now. And the last but not the least point is, mastery can't be derived at any formula. Now, people often tend to do a mistake that, you know, various people try to share of the quotes about Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Albert Einstein, and various other things as well. And they think that these people have done, let's say, A plus B equals to C stuff as well. So naturally, if I'll do all these things as well, I'll also derive the same result as well. But the fact is, as I really said in the beginning of this video as well, it's really like everyone is unique. Everyone has their own innate inclination as well. Everyone has their own unique DNA as well. You just can't, you know, logically reason about why you feel attracted or why you feel inclined towards the particular stuff as well. And that is something which is cannot be figured out as well. And if you're trying to fit yourself into those formula or thus into that all those superficial instances, then you might be doing some of those crazy mistakes up right there. And this is something really not good about. Instead of, you should find your own path. You should find your own value as well. Last but not the least, you should have a capability to handle criticism by everyone around you. The world isn't really a fair place, you know, and although people do give a valuable insight about your progress and what you do around there to really catalyze your process to achieve the mastery as well. And people really give a valuable insight, and although some shittier advice as well, but we are not going to talk about that. But yeah, you should have an capability to handle the criticism as well. Sometimes the people will make rude comments on you. Sometimes the comments will be really helpful for you as well. And you need to filter all of this comment, whether it's valuable or not. And if you are, and if you have a craving for admiration as well, then that is a really, you know, worst thing that you can ever do as well. Because a person who is having a craving, immense craving for admiration as well, and if someone give them criticize, and someone criticize on their particular aspect as well, they would not, that the person who has the craving for admiration as well, he will not be able to withstand, or, you know, can really not be able to take that criticism really, you know, in a meaningful manner as well. And that is, you should really note about. And that really wraps up our entire video discussion about all those topics as well. But if you let me know about what this video was really helpful to you or not, how this video was really could be have done better, what could be have done more, you know, illustrative manner as well. So let me know. Till then, stay connected, stay subscribed, and I'll see you next time.